Hi everyone and welcome to today's episode. I'm super, super excited to welcome you to the guy I've just been talking with before. We did an interview for half an hour. Dr. Ian Smith.
So, so obviously, you know, like a big portion of what I do and what I'm teaching inside the sort of like the fitness aspect of my work with clients is, you know, the old school thing, calories in, calories out, but also the way of, you know, not weaken our body, but strengthen our body, meaning strengthen our metabolism and getting enough nutrition in to actually like be able to handle whatever we are doing in terms of training and nutrition and that sort of thing. Because I probably, you know, you've probably seen the same, like, you know, let's just paint a picture. Like the typical lady, you know, whatever, and she's 35, 40 years old, you know, she's going to the gym, she's on the treadmill, and she's doing a bunch of cardio for 6-7 times a week. And she might be on a calorie restricted diet on 1500 calories or whatever, and she doesn't lose weight anymore. What would you say to those people that kind of like have tried a lot of different things that might be in that category of maybe overdoing and under eating? How do you talk to them in terms of like intermittent fasting and not letting them kind of like maybe overfast themselves? And then when they then eat, they might only get like 500, 600, 700, 800, maybe 1000 calories. What do you say to those people there? Because I think a lot of them out there are doing that.
Yeah, you know, it's interesting you say that. What a great question. You know, people tend to think that when something is good, that if they do more of it, that it's going to be better. And that's not always true. Yeah. Yes, when something's good, more of it can be better, but up to a point.
Yeah.
Right? Then there becomes a point of diminishing returns, and then you move into a phase of it becomes counterproductive. So people who are at the extremes of both sides, whether consuming calories or restricting calories, those extremes tend to be counterproductive and not in any way, shape, or form healthy. And so I tell people all the time that, you know, some people want to do like a 4-hour eating window and a 20-hour fast. I mean, that is extremely rigorous to your body. And it's you know, very few people can get away with that. Really well-trained athletes could probably do something like that. But the average person trying to do that type of IF schedule would be very, very difficult. And so I caution people all the time about being patient and not thinking that by over-accelerating what you're doing that you're going to get faster results, because you're going to get results, but then it becomes unhealthy. And it also becomes unsustainable, right? Yeah. You don't want to do a program where you can't sustain the program, because the minute you get off the program, then guess what happens? All of the achievements and all of the progress you made, it starts to slide back. Yeah. So my caution to people all the time is when they talk to me and they say that they want to do something really aggressive, I discourage them from doing it. And I say to them, let's challenge yourself, but let's not do it to the point that you're tipping over the line of extremism. Does that make sense?
Yeah, totally, totally. So it's obviously, you know, I think a lot of people are, you know, there's at the extreme, and then you also have a lot of people that kind of like have tried like everything. Keto, they've done a bit of fasting, like they've done a lot of things. So what would you say is kind of like the sweet spot and the best approach if they're like, okay, I want to use intermittent fasting. I want to make sure that I get enough calories. And maybe also a little bit on the training side, what is sort of like the best match to build up a healthy body? It's sustainable and you start losing weight and more or less like you're healthy doing it.
I think that the first thing people need to do is figure out what their goals are. You have to define your goals, because depending on what your goals are, then you need to match the program with the goal, not the other way around.
Yeah.
And so if someone says, I want to just lose weight really fast, then you choose, for example, intermittent fasting, you choose it to do it with clean eating, and you choose a really aggressive schedule. You choose maybe a 16-8, 16 fasting, 8 eating, or even an 18-6. So that would be that case. If you're someone who says, hey, I want to lose weight, but I also want to increase muscle tone, right? And I want to build muscle. That's a very delicate dance you have to play.
Yeah.
Because typically the things that you do to lose weight are actually antithetical to the things you do to build muscle, right? Mm-hmm. To build muscle, you increase your calorie count. To lose weight, you decrease your calorie count. To build muscle, you want to make sure that you are not only consuming a lot of calories, but exercising and lifting weights around that calorie consumption, and you want to avoid burning off too many calories, right? When you lose weight, what do you want to do? You want to burn calories. So sometimes those two things are at heads. But what I say to people is this: the answer to that is figure out, do it in a phased approach. If you have 40 pounds to lose, for example, say to yourself, my first phase is to lose 10 pounds. I'm not going to worry about building muscle. Mm-hmm. Let's lose 10 pounds. Then the next phase is keep that 10-pound weight loss and now build lean muscle mass without gaining weight. Mm-hmm. So if you stagger what those goals are rather than trying to do them at the same time,
yeah,
then you can do it. The last option would be someone just simply is trying to gain muscle mass, right? Mm-hmm. And that's a whole different ball game. And I get this question, I talk about weight loss all the time, I get a lot of questions about how do I gain weight? How do I gain good weight, muscle weight? Mm. And the answer, unfortunately, is you have to increase your calories, you have to increase your protein intake, and you have to increase your resistance training. That is resistance bands or workout. You have to damage the muscle, exhaust the muscle in order for it to grow. Yeah. Some cardio, but not too much cardio, because you really need to bulk up. So I think that the bottom line is that people need to look at what their goals are and match the program that will help them achieve those goals.